how attempts were made to erase the memory of our victories in space. The Apollo moon missions, a technological triumph or a silver screen illusion? Professionals of the Russian University of Cinematography reveal Kubrick's secrets. How the American space propaganda machine works.
Over the past 20 years, interest in our national space program has been deliberately sidelined. If you ask an American who was the first man in space, the answer will be Alan Shepard. Yuri Gagarin was launched in a rocket that orbited the Earth. But if you think about Shepard's mission, it was just a short upwards climb of 110 miles, and after 300 miles, his rocket fell back into the ocean. It wasn't an orbital flight, it was just a kind of jump into the ocean. Gagarin reached the orbital speed of 17,672 miles per hour, but Shepard's speed was only 4,500 miles per hour, and the rocket only slightly crossed the boundary of space. 62 miles is considered the space boundary, and then fell back. And the US even came up with a special term, suborbital space flight. This is propaganda at its best. It doesn't matter whether there was an actual event or not. What's important is to engage all mass media, television, and so on.
Leonid Konovalov is a recognized cinematographer and a tutor in the University of Cinematography. Motion pictures are his occupation. His hobby is the covert forces of world politics and propaganda.
The idea promoted is that Russia only played a minor role in space exploration, and all the outstanding achievements were accomplished by the USA.
Today, Leonid Konovalov is preparing to combine his profession and his hobby. He argues on the TV channel Zvezda that he will prove that the main U.S. space achievement, the moon missions, was no more than a PR show.
The majority of the lunar surface footage can be recreated in a film studio. We cannot recreate the rocket taking off. That would cost too much. But the lunar surface footage can be created in a studio without problems.
To do this, a real moon surface, complete with craters and hills, is created in our TV network studio.
We reconstructed the lunar soil. For example, this crater is composed of a hoop and moon soil. Our lunar soil is composed of garden earth and cement. And here we created a track. This track will reach into the distance on the screen, because this screen is a continuation of our area of the lunar surface. It will produce a convincing moonscape.
When the scenery is ready, Konovalov explains what he will shoot.
Will we be able, for example, to take a lunar surface picture here, similar to this one? A man on the surface of the moon.
These days, we would simply put a green chroma key screen behind. And then on a computer, in place of the chroma key screen, there would be everything we need for the scene. But our task is to create an illusion using only the methods that existed at the time of the U.S. moon landings. That is, without using any computer graphic imagery.
For this, we have used the front projection process. This method is well known thanks to Stanley Kubrick's movie 2001: A Space Odyssey.
We'll explain later what front projection technology is. Now let's focus on director Stanley Kubrick, mentioned by our expert. He was one of the most celebrated filmmakers of the 20th century. Kubrick entered the history of space infowars as a likely director of the moon hoax. Ostensibly, he was hired by the US government to create the fake lunar landings. Disputes about what happened, a real TV broadcast, or an ingenious fabrication, have not ceased for half a century. Всеволод Якубович and Vladimir Podgubitsky are legends of Russian national cinematography. One of them has been involved in special effects all his life, and has made 80 films. The other spent all his life filming space. After watching recordings of the moon landings, what professional conclusions have they reached?
During the passage of this rover, some mistakes were made during filming.
Допущены при съемке некоторые ошибки.
The jumps of the scale model needed to be longer and more spectacular.
Прыжки макета.
In my opinion, this is a scale model with a dummy. Look at his arm, the left arm of the astronaut, who seems to be holding the camera and at the same time driving the rover. It doesn't move. A normal person cannot keep his arm in this position. That's why I think it was a scale model used in this sequence. This is the same scene, but sped up. These scenes were shot on Earth at a speed of about 75 frames per second. You see, here the shots had to be breathtaking. There are the jumps, like this one. This was primarily done in order to convince ordinary people everywhere. I'm afraid that organizing such a filming session on the surface of the moon, from start to finish, was impossible. It would have required too much equipment, much more than they were able to deliver to the surface of the moon. Russian astronomers have shown that the moon is brown in color. And in places it is dark brown, as rye bread, or a crust of rye bread. Here behind me you see three pictures of the moon. Two of them were taken by a digital camera. The middle one was shot on movie film, and all of them are brown in color. And now let's see how the US astronauts photographed the lunar surface and themselves on the moon. We see that everywhere the moon is gray. I made a composite with all six landings, all six flags, and next to them is a picture of the actual brown moon. Yellow squares mark lunar landings as documented by NASA. All of them are brown. Why did the Americans take pictures with a gray lunar surface? I can only come to one conclusion. The flag and the astronauts were not on the moon.
But the debunker of the record, Leonid Konovalov, is absolutely sure all the moon missions were staged and produced in low quality.
I think they're hopelessly poor efforts. Only thanks to the propaganda and due to the fact that many people, 90% of people around the world, have never seen more than 15 seconds of the moon footage at any one time.
He is in no doubt. In the studio we can easily and convincingly recreate those moon landings.
This is a cosmonaut's helmet. It's our probe. And here are, it would seem, regular shoes. But they are very special for us, because they have a sole pattern which is very reminiscent of the footprints that were made on the lunar surface. Therefore, these are treasured and very important items of our equipment.
Once again, for this production, we will use only those film techniques which were available in 1969, primarily the so-called front projection method.
So what is it? This is when an image is projected onto the big screen of a special material called scotch light, containing very small beds, and an actor performs in front of this image, against the screen.
So, the main thing in the front projection method is that screen. The scotch light material is well known to you. It is used, for example, on retroreflective elements of clothing, or on the road signs, so that they reflect in vehicle headlights at night. By the way, the fabled laser swords in the first Star Wars were made from Scotch light. If a Scotch light screen is constructed and an image is projected on it, then the image is reflected and appears to be behind the actor, standing next to the adjacent wall. That's the special effect it produces.
The fan projection technique is used when one needs to place a person into a landscape. Here in our studio, the screen width is 16 feet, while Stanley Kubrick in 2001, A Space Odyssey, had a screen of 100 feet wide.
Nevertheless, you sure it will work. And now the projector with a moonscape transparency is turned on. Watch carefully.
Смотрите внимательно.
Konovalov says this is how the Americas had landed on the moon in 1969. And that, in his opinion, is not the only fakery in the Apollo space propaganda.
For example, when we see the very first US spacewalk by Ed White in 1965, 3 months after Alexei Leonov, I immediately realized that this was just a composite picture.
American astronaut Ed White made a spacewalk 3 months after Alexei Leonov. Konovalov says that Americans could not admit that they simply didn't have the means to work in space. As a result, this photo can easily be seen through. It's poorly produced.
The man is dangling on a rope. That's why his arms and his legs hang like that. He is suspended from the back. This is by no means a real EVA. It's just a falsification. As if trying to catch up with Soviet Union, they shot an alleged EVA in a studio. It's a trick of photography.
Alexei Leonov has left the spacecraft. The man is in interplanetary space. He is alive, he is working, and is smiling. It is clear that if the lunar landings were a hoax, then it would have required an alliance between the secret services and Hollywood. Some took care of the secrecy, others shot the fake material. The likely technology has been demonstrated by cinematographer Konovalov. And now he is ready to recreate this episode of the US Moon Saga.